أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. قل يا عبادي الذين أسرفوا على أنفسهم لا تقنطوا من رحمة الله إن الله يغفر الذنوب جميعا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. فالحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. قرآن ويكلي. Now we're on the 24th juz, and I'm sharing with you an ayah from Surah Az-Zumar, the 39th surah, and this is the 53rd ayah of the surah. In this ayah, the first thing to note is the word قل. Allah says say, which means He's commanding the Prophet to convey a message. And this is important because this is supposed to be a message of hope. And the first thing we're learning is the people who will deliver the message of Islam, part of their job is to make sure that they themselves personally deliver hope. That's captured inside قُل. Allah could have spoken to the people directly, يَا عِبَادِيَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ, my slaves who've wronged among them, who've done violations against themselves. He didn't say that. He said, say, my slaves who've wronged themselves, or who have done wrong to themselves, or crossed the limits against themselves. But I'll get to that part later. The first thing to note is قُل. The Prophet is supposed to go and deliver hope. The Prophet is supposed to put somebody, his hand on someone's shoulder, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and tell them it's okay. Here's what Allah has to say to you. I have something that Allah said to you directly that I want to share with you. Then ya ibadi, my slaves. Ibad is actually different from abid. Abid is used for all the slaves in the Quran specifically. Abid is used for slaves that don't obey Allah. This is abid. Wama Allahu yuridu dhulman lil abid. Allah doesn't intend wrong for the abid. They do wrong themselves. But ibad is used for good slaves. And in this ayah, it's actually about sinners. But Allah is saying, you can still be my slaves. You can make tawbah. Alladhina asrafu ala anfusihim. Those who went overboard against themselves, who overdid it, who crossed the line, who got close to the haram and then went into the haram. And you did that wrong against yourself and you feel really, really bad that you did. You're still my slaves. Don't cut yourself off from me. You commit a sin and you're afraid to look back. There's a mountain of sin behind you, so when you want to turn back to Allah, instead of seeing Allah or instead of meeting with Allah, you just meet with the sin in your past. Allah says, I know you've done something wrong against yourselves. And I know that sin is huge. And that sin is so depressing that you don't even want to think about coming back to Allah anymore. You're like, who am I to come back to Allah? My sin is too huge. Allah says, "La ala anfusihim la taqnatu min rahmatillah." Don't cut yourself off and don't lose hope. Don't be depressed from the mercy and love and care of Allah. Don't think that Allah is telling you, don't think that His love and His care and His concern is so small that your sin is bigger than it. It's bigger than that. There's never going to be a time in your life where you can still inhale and exhale and Allah's mercies, the doors to Allah's mercy are closed. No matter what you've done. No matter what you've done. If Allah can open the door to those who will be in the lowest pit of hellfire, إِنَّ الْمُنَافِقِينَ فِي الدَّرْكِ الْأَسْفَلِ مِنَ النَّارِ, hypocrites are going to be in the lowest pit of the hellfire. إِلَّا الَّذِينَ تَابُوا, except those who repent. Even they can repent. The guy was headed not just to hell, to the lowest part of hell, and Allah says he can repent. And here he's not even talking like, يَا أَيُّهَا الْمُنَافِقُونَ الَّذِينَ أَصْرَفُوا عَلَىٰ أَنفُسِهِمْ. He didn't say, oh hypocrites who wronged themselves. No, you're still my servants. You're not even headed for the lowest pit of hellfire. Why should you lose hope in Allah? Even the hypocrite can have hope in Allah. He can come back out of his hypocrisy. So you should never, ever think that you are beyond hope with Allah. And don't confuse what people think of you with what Allah thinks of you. People might think you're an evil person, you're bad, they've written you off. Allah never writes you off. Allah is the only one who never writes you off. You know? There will be people that are messed up. I mean, they do all kinds of messed up stuff. But they have some little connection with Allah left. One prayer every Friday. That's all they got left. Maybe you're one of those guys. All they got left is Eid prayer. That's it. That's the only connection to God they have left. The only thing this person has left is like fasting in Ramadan. Not even every day. every once in a while. That's all he's got left. At least you left that one door open. At least you left that door open. But don't you think that that door is enough? Now that you've left that door open, turn back and face Allah. Turn back to Him and accept that you've made mistakes. He's your master. And your master is telling you he loves you. That he wants you back. That he wants you to turn back to him. That he wants you to rethink your life. If you give Allah a chance, Allah Azza wa Jal is waiting. And the offer he's making to you, for you, you know, because you've done so much wrong. I mean, it's a lot of wrong. Allah says, what will he do if you can turn back to him? إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا. No doubt about it, Allah is going to, He in fact will cover the mistakes, will forgive, will overlook the mistakes, all of them. Don't say, but what about that one? All of them. No, what about this one? All of them. It's done. You just turn back to Allah. You make tawbah to Allah. You decide you're starting new again. You can do that, and Allah Azza wa Jal will accept your tawbah. I pray sincerely that this is the month. We're closing out the month. We've got a few days left. This is the time to ask Allah to forgive. And ask Allah, Ya Allah, let me get a fresh start. I know I've wronged myself. I know I've done plenty and plenty and plenty of wrong. Sit there and just talk to Allah at night. Just talk to Allah. Tell Allah what you've been doing. Admit to Allah. Confess to Allah what you've been doing. I don't care if you do it in English or Urdu or Bangla. It doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. And you have to do it in Arabic. I don't care if you don't know a single dua. I don't care if you don't know any Arabic. Just talk to Allah. Tell Allah what you've been doing. Cry about it to Allah. Those tears are going to bring you closer to Allah than you've ever been before. But they have to be real. And they have to be just you and Allah and nobody else. That conversation has to start. And then Allah's offer is, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا إِنَّهُ هُوَ الْغَفُورُ الرَّحِيمُ. He's the one that is incredibly merciful, incredibly forgiving. He's the one that always envelops you in care, envelops you in love, who shows you mercy, who shows you kindness. I pray that this is the month. This is the week even. I forget month. Month is gone. This is the week. That is your week. This is the week you start new. This is the week where all your previous sins are gone and you start as a slave of Allah that has come close to Him and He's taken Allah up on the offer that He gave Him in this blessed, beautiful, beautiful month. I pray that Allah Azza wa Jal gives you that strength, and I pray all the best for you in your life, in the life of your family, and in the life of all of those that are around you, that you become a source of blessing for them and a source of them getting closer to Allah through you getting closer to Allah. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum. Quran Weekly.